With over 500 collaborations with prestigious international agencies, Makerere ranks among the top 100 universities worldwide for its partnerships, driving forward its mission to shape the global discourse on education and innovation.
We pride ourselves in being the most internationally connected university in terms of collaborations and the MOUs we learn with the peer institutions world over.
Makerere is actually considered the most collaborative university in the world by Times Higher Education. According to them, there are more researchers at Makerere University who publish with the researcher at another university than any other university in the world. And that's why you see that our ranking is high despite our limited resources.
Makerere University has got academic staff who conduct research, 1,500. And of those, about 800 of them have got PhDs.
The university's journey has not stopped with the reconstruction of the Ivory Tower. Significant strides have been made in other areas such as renovating student residences, digitizing academic records and processes, and developing modern facilities and assistive technologies to support students with disabilities. These efforts demonstrate a commitment to inclusivity, modernity, and innovation, creating a nurturing environment where every student has the opportunity to thrive.
This is something that is going to aggrandize the safety of university records. You realize that if someone is abroad, they will not need to come to Makerere to pick their transcripts or any other academic documents that they will need maybe to advance their studies somewhere else. So these are initiatives that really were long overdue for a centennial institution like Makerere University.
The School of Law was in dilapidated buildings. The School of Law has produced virtually all our judges, including the Chief Justice. But the buildings were really dilapidated, not befitting the standard of a university like Makerere, which is an international university.
Makerere University has also been a cradle of leadership for Africa, producing numerous post-independence leaders, including Uganda's former president Milton Obote and Tanzania's late president Julius Nyerere. These distinguished alumni underscore the university's enduring influence on the continent's political and intellectual landscape.
I think the most prominent alumnus of Makerere University is Julius Nyerere. He embodied the spirit of what Plato called a philosopher king. He was a man of action, but also a man of thought. In Kenya, Governor Peter Anyang' Nyong'o was guild president of Makerere at one time. And then there are those who shaped Makerere, like Professor Mazrui. Makerere is not only in politics, Makerere is also in the fields of medicine, in the field of engineering, and I do believe that they continue to serve with dignity, honor, and competence.
The Ivory Tower stands tall once more, a beacon of hope and a testament to the enduring spirit of Makerere University.
I remember I had calls from people in Canada, people from France who were saying, look, we can create chapters here and raise money to fund its renovation, its restoration. But government stepped in strongly and the president said no. So he was very passionate about that and said, we'll fund it. And they actually gave us all the money that we needed, not just for its build, but also for the interior.
We want to thank the people of Uganda who kept encouraging us and when we told them, no, we are going to reconstruct the building. And we hope that on second, we will all be rejoicing, not just for the reopening of the building, but marking a new era in Makerere's history.
The rebirth of the Ivory Tower is not just a return to the past, it is a bold leap into a transformative future. The journey of progress and innovation is just the beginning. The road ahead is bright, and pursuit of knowledge and transformation continues.